So what if you're totally new to credit? You know, what are some of the best practices for somebody that's just getting started out with credit cards and leveraging lines of credit to build wealth? Well, we're gonna break that down. I'm gonna give you guys my top three tips in today's training. Hey everyone, it's Mike Adams, and on this channel, we empower individuals to achieve freedom through improved financial literacy and business ownership. If you're new to the channel, make sure to click subscribe and click the bell so that way you get notified on any and all of our future training. So in this video, guys, I wanted to give you my top three tips, okay, for beginners and folks that are new to getting lines of credit and credit cards and leveraging them to build wealth. And really, these are some of the things that you just need to be thinking about and need to be aware of when you're entering this world of grabbing lines of credit and trying to build wealth. One of the things that I just don't want on this channel is someone to watch one of my videos and then it's like, okay, I'm gonna go out there and I'm just gonna start applying and just get all these credit cards and not really have, you know, the game plan or the strategy. I mean, that's not what it's all about. You know, we're not looking to just stockpile lines of credit that we don't have a specific plan for. And we have actually talked about that in another video that I'll link to below this video, just so that we understand that there's all kinds of, you know, reasons that you want to have to actually enter this world of getting lines of credit. But let's say you've made that decision. You say, Mike, I've seen some of the things you're talking about on this channel. I want to use some of those techniques, but I don't have a credit card. I don't have a line of credit. How do I get started? And I want to do this the right way, right? I want to build myself a strong credit profile here. You know, what do I need to be thinking about when I enter this world of getting lines of credit? So really what I wanted to do is just kind of break it down to a couple of things that you need to be thinking about. I actually got three things that you need to be considering when you're entering this world of getting lines of credit. And these will really be my three tips, okay, for beginners to using credit cards. And really, these three tips will get you on the right track for how to properly start using your lines of credit. So the first thing that you need to know and really just kind of have at the forefront of your mind is a thing called age of file, okay? And we have other videos where we break down the different factors that actually make up your credit score and then and some of the factors that really make for a strong, strong score. And age of file is one of them, okay? And age of file, what that means, there's really two things that are looked at there. Number one is the age of your oldest active account, okay? And then number two, the average age of all of your accounts, okay? So let's say you had a, you got a credit card that you've had for 10 years and a credit card that you've had for, let's say, 2 years. Well, that's 12 years total, two cards. That'd be a 6-year average, right? So the age of the oldest active account and then the average age of your active accounts, okay? So why is that important for beginners? Well, you know, when you get that first line of credit, you are establishing, it's like you're planting that flag in the ground. This is when I'm starting to play the game of credit, right? This is my age of oldest account. When you get that first line of credit, guys, plan on keeping that line of credit for life, okay? And that might sound crazy. It's like, for life? What do you mean for life? In my wallet, and I've actually talked about this in another training, I have an old, it's a Best Buy, and if they're still in business, but it's a Best Buy Reward Zone credit card that was one of the first cards that I ever got in my early 20s, and it had a very low limit. I think it just had a $200 limit, and now I think the line only has like a $1,500 limit. It's not a line that we use at all, but the number one thing about that is that card, and the reason that I keep it, even though I don't use it for my strategies, I don't use it for investing, I don't use it for anything huge, right? It just kind of gets a transaction a year just to stay active. But the reason that we keep that line and we'll never close it is because that is our oldest aged account. And if we were to eliminate that line, it is going to, number one, reduce the age of our oldest aged active account, which could hurt your credit. And number two, it's going to reduce your average. Okay, so let's say, again, I had those two lines of credit, a 10-year and a 2-year. If I go ahead and close the 2-year, or I'm sorry, if I go ahead and close the 10-year out of the equation, now I just have the one line with 2 years. Well, now my average age of accounts went to 2 years. And now as well, my oldest open account is only 2 years. So instead of me having that 10 years of history, now it only looks like I have two. So when you get that for those first couple lines of credit, guys, plan on keeping those for the long haul, because they're gonna factor into your credit score over the long haul. Now, my second tip for beginners to using lines of credit is to get a secured credit card. And there's all kinds of fantastic, you know, Discover It has one, but there's all kinds of different credit cards that have what's called a secured card. And that's a great place for a lot of folks to get started with establishing credit. So what is the difference here between a secured card and an unsecured card? With an unsecured card, like if you apply, let's say you already have good credit and you just go ahead and apply for a credit card and you get approved for it, Okay, you have just gotten approved for an unsecured credit card, meaning it's not backed by anything. A secured credit card, and many times, you know, if somebody has either bad credit or no credit, this is the way that you'll have to go, is get yourself a secured card. And what they do, how it works, is you're gonna put down a deposit. Let's say it's $200, $500, $1,000, whatever it is. That deposit's going to be held by the bank that is issuing you the secured credit card. You now have this secured credit card that you can now use, and the limit of that card is typically gonna be the exact amount of the deposit that you put in. So if you put in $1,000, well, they give you a credit card now with a $1,000 limit, okay? Now, what does that mean? Okay, you can rack that up, and what that means is if you were to ever default on that card, the $1,000 that you gave them is what they would recoup. Now, a couple great things about secured lines of credit is, again, number one, you don't have to worry about getting yourself into too much trouble with a secured line because, again, the line is only gonna be as big as a deposit that you gave them. And this allows you to start using credit. You're allowed to start, you can start using that credit card. You can pay it off at the end of the month. And then from there, over time, the bank that issued you the secured card, they start doing a couple things. You start showing a little bit of a track record over 6 months to a year of leveraging that line, paying it on time, never being late, all that good stuff, and using it properly, okay? Two things can happen. Number one is they could increase the limit on your line. So even though you handed them 1,000, okay, after a year of good use, now they say, hey, we're gonna keep the 1,000, but now we're gonna up your limit to 2,000, giving you an extra $1,000 worth of leverage to play with. They may actually turn around and give you back your security deposit and say, hey, we're gonna convert this card from a secured card over to an unsecured line of credit, which would again mean that your scores are starting to go up, and that is very, very good news. And tip number three here is to show active, responsible use of your new line of credit. So here's what I mean by that. You know, every month you have bills that you're going to pay, right? You're gonna pay your cell phone bill, you're gonna pay your utility bill, your Netflix bill, whatever it is, okay? And you're gonna pay certain bills every single month. What I recommend is that you show some activity on that line every single month as you're getting started out, and pay that line off every single month, okay? So utilize that line of credit to pay all of your normal expenses, and then use your income to pay down that line of credit all the way down to zero every single month, okay? After 6 to 12 months of doing that, you're gonna be showing the bank that, hey, you know, you are wanting to use credit, you are wanting to leverage this line, you're actively using it. On the bank side, they're thinking, okay, great, because every time they use it, there's always that chance he's gonna leave a balance and we're gonna get you for interest, right? So the bank likes to see activity. They want to know that you want to play the credit game. And again, if you're showing that responsible use, like you use it and you pay it off every single month, number one, you're not paying any interest. And again, you're showing that consistent activity and responsible use. Typically what will happen there, especially if you're starting up with a secured card, or even if you're starting up with a low limit unsecured card, when you start using it in this fashion over 6 to 12 months, banks like that, and it opens up the door for potential credit limit increases. And we've talked about that in other videos as well, where you should request increases frequently, typically when you're showing improved credit and responsible use consistently, and you're not carrying a balance, every 6 to 12 months, you could be looking to get a credit limit increase, whether it's from a secured card, get an increase there, or if you're on unsecured, get an increase there. So again, those are the three things that you really wanna be focused on when you're getting those first couple lines of credit. Number one, think age of file. So when you get these first couple of lines, plan on keeping them for the long haul, because they're gonna factor into the strength of your overall credit. Number two, get started if you need to with a secured line of credit, so that way you can start utilizing that line. And then number three, show that active, responsible use by utilizing that credit card simply for your regular monthly expenses, and then paying that bill off every single month. And when I say your regular monthly expenses, I'm talking about the ones that you pay in full every month, no matter what. So hopefully you guys found value in this training. If you did, give it a comment, give it a like below. I will see you guys in the next video. We'll be right back.